welcome once again, Municipal Auditorium here in Nashville, Grand Ole Opry style, and that's what we have here, the Little Monsoon, along with the Reverend Slick, as we take a look at Virgil.
Yeah, boy, there he is, my boy from the, my homeboy from the Amen Corner.
Tell me, Virgil was one of your first conversion.
Exactly. And I'll tell you what, he's a great guy, great individual, that Virgil is.
I understand he needed it too, Reverend.
Well, you know, he's been known to be a little bit there on the wild side.
Well,
honky-tonking and going on, you know what I mean?
What a tremendous athlete Virgil is. He'll have his hands full with young Spicoli, who's really come a long way in the last year.
Yes, he has. Very much improved.
Nice tuck underneath into the hammerlock, and whoa, gets met with an elbow right in the kisser.
Well, he's a wild individual. He knows his way around the ring. Virgil won't have an easy go of it, I'll tell you.
Drop kick finds the mark by Virgil. Side headlock for control, and look at this.
My main man is looking real good, fine-tuned. Virgil's really improving himself, you know, Gorilla?
Well, he came here to the World Wrestling Federation, Reverend, and sort of went about things the wrong way. Needed to see the light. And I understand, Reverend, that after some long conversations with you, he certainly did.
Well, exactly. You know, I think what this ministry is all about is sharing. And I certainly wanted Virgil to be one of my first converts. We've been friends a long time. I want to see him on my side. I want to be on his side.
Good for you. Irish Whip coming up here now. Nice reversal. Wow. Spicoli with a nice shoulder block. Virgil down quickly in front, over the top. Leapfrog, reverse monkey flip, yes. Oh, close line, 360, Spicoli's out of there.
Well, you can bet he'll be shaking his head outside there. I'll tell you what, there goes Virgil after him.
How about that? Flying Virgil.
Well, he didn't quite catch him like he wanted to, but he had enough from his impact, I'll tell you, to knock him down.
He's upset.
Exactly. Not like Virgil to go winning away with the fist right away, but I'll tell you, he gave two or three good haymakers there.
You know, early on in his career, Reverend, that was one of his big faults. He'd get all bent out of shape, lose control, and lose matches.
Exactly. But, you know, like I said, he's gaining more experience. He's looking great now. He seems more confident in himself and maybe more self-esteem. What do you think, Gorilla?
Well, I think a lot of the poise that Virgil possesses right now is due to your pal, Hot Rod, Roddy Piper.
What a great influence he's had on the Virgil's career.
Uh-oh. Might have a leg injury here. Nice reverse thrust kick by Spicoli. Over for the leg. Well, he hooked the leg, but still couldn't get it.
Well, I tell you what, that Spicoli, he's presenting quite a challenge to Virgil.
He certainly is. Elbow drop into the sternum.
There, that inexperience again. Not a good cover at all.
Boy, he should have went for a couple of more offensive moves and then tried to get it. Virgil, maybe got the wind knocked out of him here.
Well, good move by Spicoli. I have to give him credit. He's done his homework a little bit here.
Oh, look at this. Covered in. Virgil hooks the double arm hook and still couldn't get the youngster. Spicoli with a nice clothesline.
Well, you know, that's twice he's taken Virgil off his feet. I think Virgil may have underestimated this man's strength.
Well, that's very possible. Sometimes you don't do your homework. And they tell me in his younger days, Virgil never liked to do his homework.
Well, that's exactly what I wanted to get to next.
Get him off my head!
Well, Spicoli now, reverse chin lock. Thought I heard Virgil complaining he was getting his hair pulled. Highly unlikely, Virgil.
Well, it'd be a miracle again, I'll tell you. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a little choke going on in there, too. Well, this crowd's really behind Virgil. He's got him in his pocket, look like.
Well, start that old adrenaline flowing through that body. Couple of elbows buy some time. Virgil now, whoa! What a nice placement of the knee by Spicoli right in the breadbasket.
And believe me, that hurt. You see how Virgil's holding that stomach?
Here.
Well, somebody needs to work with this guy. I'll tell you, he's not doing his homework. There are two or three times he may have caused an upset here this evening.
Anything can happen. Anybody can be beaten on any given week here in the World Wrestling. Look at that. What a beautiful suplex by Spicoli. Mojo with enough momentum to get out. Just about.
Well, speaking of momentum, I think all the momentum right now is with Spigoli. Look like everything's going his way.
Well, Virgil obviously, Reverend, thinking about something else. And wishing at this point in time he were somewhere else.
Well, it looks like it. But let's don't count the homeboy out yet.
Oh, definitely not. Couple of elbows, sets him free once again. Leapfrog over the top, look out, side suplex. That found the mark.
Virgil a little slow in getting up himself.
Well, he's still trying to clear the cobwebs. He took quite a pounding here for 4 or 5 minutes from Spicoli.
All right, the juices seem to be flowing now.
He's up on those toes.
Patented Virgil now.
Shades of Muhammad Ali. Reverse knife edge, Irish whip coming up, look out. Downstairs once again. Suplex. Yes. Well executed.
Very well. Very well. Here he goes. Let's see what he's going to do next.
Well, he gave that wrap-up sign. Neckbreaker, well executed. Over for the cover. Oh, wow. Did he make it look
good? What a great match. I'll tell you. What a great comeback. Virgil seemed to be in trouble quite a bit there. But there he stands victorious. Well, I told you, don't count the homeboy out yet.
Absolutely not. The lovely Mike McGurk proclaiming Virgil the winner. Plenty more big ones still to come here this week on Primetime Wrestling. We'll be back.